Okay, good afternoon, everyone. My name is William. I work for IR. I'm going to spend the next 15-20 minutes to speak about the future of kiosk at the airport. Certainly, it's a broad topic, and I would like to understand with you why the industry is focusing on this particular topic, what kind of opportunities we can have from the future kiosk at the airport, and also to define the way of different trends we can see at the airport. Before starting, I would like to introduce quickly the company I work for, AIA. It's a French company, part of Bolloré Group. So it's a kiosk manufacturer for airport and airlines. Since 1962, we provide solutions for the transport industry to improve the passenger flow. The headquarters is based next to Paris, in Suresnes, and this year we will manufacture around 600 kiosks for airlines, airport, and rail operator. So, what is a kiosk? Does anyone here know about kiosk, or is that something? Okay, you sir. So, basically, what we name common use self-service. It's a simple definition would be a boarding pass printer in a box. But I would say it's a bit more than that. There are many initiatives linked to the term of service kiosk. Whether there are initiatives led by consultants, by individual airport, or engineering firms, this is clearly a topic that stays on many minds. So kiosk, it means that multiple airlines can use the same kiosk. Passengers can check in, so either airlines they use to the same self-service kiosk. Generally, it's a four-step process, and I'm going to go through to all this process. Step one, the passenger arrives in front of the kiosk and selects the airlines he's flying with. Step two, he finds his booking through different ways. You have obviously the passport reader, you have the booking reference, or you have the boarding pass if you have checked in with your mobile. The step three, you choose a seat in the aircraft if you didn't check in before, or you can use a payment module if you want to increase or to add extra services. Like your bag is heavier than the airline's policy, so you need to add extra bag, or you want to access the lounge, so you can pay your lounge access at the kiosk. Different add-ons. Finally, the step four, it's the addition of the boarding pass and the bag tag. That's the main steps of the kiosk. The question is, why do we use a kiosk check-in? It's not something recent. It has been 17 years old. But today we have over 300 locations using the kiosk and over 90 airlines. For the passenger, it saves time as he doesn't need to go to find the kiosk of the dedicated airlines. They can see the aircraft layout and obviously to choose their seat if they didn't check in previously. And it allows them to spend more time in the terminal or in the duty-free area where they can spend money and to relax before the flight. For the airlines, it cut costs as they have less or no capital spending and they have their own brand on the shared self-service kiosk. For the airport, obviously, it saves space and presents a better airport as there will be less kiosks. Could you just imagine if all the airlines at the airport, they had their own kiosk, it would be a mess. And like that, you can save space to add retail opportunities to bring some WHS boots into your airport to obviously increase the airport revenue. The kiosk beyond check-in. Obviously, nowadays, we find more and more the mobile check-in or the web check-in. So it's something that moving the check-in outside the airport. But we still need kiosk. It's what we want to make people understand. Because For us, simply printing a boarding pass at a Qusk kiosk, it doesn't maximize the value of the kiosk. I will explain. So the basics of the Qusk kiosk, what is it? Basically, you have a touch screen, more and more bright. This one is the current shape, I would say, of the kiosk you can find at the airport. Nowadays, what are the new trend is to only have one screen, like a kind of iPad in the hand, feelings, more to improve the feeling of the passenger. You have also the boarding pass printer on the bell of the kiosk. The barcode reader is compulsory to read passport, to read boarding pass if the passenger checked in before. We have also the dual backpack printer to obviously add the label on the bag if the passenger wants to drop a bag. And you have the payment module if you want to add any extra, as I said, lounge access or any other extra you want to add for your journey. The new kiosk usage. So basically, the question is how to improve the passenger journey with the new kiosk usage. There is many ways. The self-service check-in. 86% of passengers, they had access to self-service check-in option. The flight rebooking. 2 billion travelers, it's around 64 of global passengers, have access to the flight rebooking through kiosk. The document checked is about 52% of the travelers that have the possibility to scan their travel documents themselves. The bag recovery. 21 airlines nowadays, they use the bag recovery kiosk at the arrival to declare that, yes, there is a bag missing. I want to focus on two specific areas of the new kiosk usage. And I will focus first on the self backdrop. So I'm sure many of you flew from or to Gatwick. And if you fly from Gatwick, you've seen that EasyJet deployed 50 positions of self-backdrop. So you can see that it's offered by next year, 74% of airlines will offer this service. When it has been introduced first in 2013, the backdrop, the passenger used to spend on average more than 100 seconds to drop the bag. And nowadays, from Gatwick source, it's less than 50 seconds. So in less than 5 years, it decreased by half. When we check the time, I mean, it's the entire process. From the time the passenger will arrive to the kiosk, as you can see here, to check in, to scan the passport, or to scan the boarding pass, to label the bag, to put the bag on the BHS, the baggage handling system, and to make the bag going to the conveyor belt. So it's really something that we reduce the operation cost for the airport and to enable the passenger to have a full self-service from the check-in to drop a bag. One of the benefits I would like to also highlight is the fact that this kind of system, this kind of service, it's available 24 hours, 7 days a week, where you can sometimes have some issue with staff. So another thing that it's something that we need to redeem the human or the support from staff, obviously not, but there will always be a room to find the right balance of a staff here to check if the system is fully operational and to leave the passenger having their own self-service system. Today in Gatwick, you still can see some EasyJet staff helping people. And it's much more either reduced mobility passenger or either old people or actually new user of this technology. Another area I would like to focus on is the flight to get. So the flight to get is a concept which is recently has been launched. Basically, what does it mean? It means that you have a kiosk where you go and you check in, like if it's a basic self-service check-in. But on this kiosk, you have a camera. So meaning that when you scan your passport, the kiosk takes a picture of your face. Then you take all your bag, you go to the bag drop, you drop your bag if you have a bag. If you don't have a bag, you go directly to the security. At the security, you show your passport to the security officer. And while his name fly to get, when you arrive at the boarding gate, instead of like airline staff to check your ID and your boarding pass, it's an automatic gate, meaning that you're gonna scan again your passport and another picture is taken. This picture will have to match the previous pictures that has been taken into the kiosk. This concept allow passenger to definitely fly to get. It's a better flow of passenger through the airport to obviously to not have too many queues at the airport. It helps with the biometric verification to be sure of the authentication of the passenger. And it's something that currently the low cost carrier are really look into to avoid to hire more staff and to have less, we'll say, operational issue with passenger. To sum up, over the past few years, we have seen the introduction of many self-check-in kiosks at the airport. A number of airlines have recently moved to a full dedicated automation process for their passenger. EasyJet, British Airways. For a millennial traveler like me, to be honest, I don't mind if I got a full automated process when I go to the airport. I don't mind to meet an agent or to have some indication of what to do. But I have a concern for passengers who are older or reduced people. We still need to tell them how to do. So there will be always a staff next to them. Now the question would be to what do you think of a fully automated solution? Is that something that you are keen on? Or is that something that definitely you would prefer to interact with some people? Thank you. Do you have any questions? I wanted to be really simple and clear on this one because self-service at the airport, it's a really, really wide topic. And nowadays, there's many trends at the airport. We hear about blockchain, we hear about IoT, we hear about all the APIs. The self-service is something that IR is dedicated to improve the experience at the airport for the passenger. Any questions? Thank you.